and to each and every one of you that have come out today. We want to also thank Sister T.R. Willis, who is the director of the youth. Come on, let's give her a hand. She is doing a wonderful job. And without further ado, we should turn it over now to our mistress of ceremony, Sister Aretha McKenzie, in Jesus' name.
Share who we are. I have a poem that said, I am who God say I am. Do you know who you are? We are redeemed. We are forgiven. We are peculiar. We are chosen. We are a royal priesthood, called out of darkness into his marvelous light. This means we come from royalty, so we ought to act like it. Royalty is humble. No need to boast. At one glance, look, people know who you are. Your presence radiates who you are, who you belong to. We are royalty, redeemed, forgiven, the essence of godly presence. We don't have to speak or utter a word. Our presence, made in the image of God, says it. I am who God says I am. This is a reference, 1 Peter 2:9. This was written by Sister Aretha McKenzie. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. At this time, thank you. At this time, we're going to have our opening song by our choir.
From heaven above with
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, we're going to have Brother Tyshawn Longwood come give us our prayer. Give him a hand as he comes up.
Bow our heads and close our eyes. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us to be here on this Sunday. Thank you, Lord, for everybody who has gathered here to witness the Easter program that is happening today. Thank you, Lord, for everybody who worked hard and put together this Easter program to present to you today and to all the ones in the room. Thank you, Lord, for putting roofs over our head, shoes on our feet, clothes on our back, and keeping us safe and in your arms of protection at all times. Thank you, Lord, for strengthening us in your ways and keeping us safe with everything we do and everything we desire. Thank you, Lord, for carving out paths for each and every one of us everywhere we go and everywhere we seek. Thank you, Lord, for all making us ones in you and seeking your will and word every day. Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good job. Hallelujah. We thank the Lord. Hallelujah for being here. At this time, we're going to ask Brother Elite Johnson to come give us our scripture. Elite Johnson. All right. Give him a hand as he come up.
I'm reading Matthew 28th chapter, 1 to 10.
He's giving you guys time to look it up.
In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulcher. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning and his raiment white as snow. And fear of him keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the women, fear not, yea, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen. As he said, come see the place where the Lord lay. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. And they have departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. And as they went to go tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, all hail. And they came and held him by the feet and worshipped him. And then they said, Jesus unto them, be not afraid, go tell my brethren that they go unto Galilee, and there thou shalt see me.
Amen, amen. Good job. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, at this time, this is what we've been waiting for. We're going to start with our speeches. So please sit quietly, sit tight, and listen to what the children have to say about God's resurrection. We're going to start out with Trinity Johnson. Give her a hand as she comes up.
We are glad to welcome you at this Easter time so bright. In the name of him who rose and banners Calvary night, may all of Easter joy light, may blessing sunshine too, wish as you works out with us in blessing days coming for you.
Beautiful. Good job. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Next, we're going to have Noah Johnson come up and share his speech. Give him a hand as he come up.
Easter morning, Easter joy. God's gift to every girl and boy.
All right, give them a hand. Make sure you take a bow, Noah. Take a bow, y'all. All right, we're going to move on. Next, we're going to have Jatara Kelly. Give her a hand as she comes up.
Every proclaim it, that one for good is seen. How you use it and cause it is indeed.
Beautiful, beautiful. Good job, good job. Now we're going to have Riley Durant come up. Give her a hand as she come up.
God is good. God gave us things that we need. God gave us clothes. God gave us TVs. God gave us a house. God gave us things that we barely have. Even homeless women don't have things, or men. Anyways, we can help them too by giving them money and buying them food.
All right, good job, beautiful. Next, we're going to have Jalen Kelly.
Today, you've heard the story of sacrifice Jesus made, and we hope you let him in your heart and give him a place to stay.
Very beautiful, very beautiful. Now, we're going to have Alyssa Parrott come up. Give her a hand as she comes up.
If I stood there by the cross the day that Jesus died, would I have left him hanging there, my Jesus crucified? It was for me he took my place so I could always live with him in heaven forevermore. What a beautiful gift to give. I'm glad that Jesus rose again. I love him, indeed I do. And I know he loves you and me in every day, on every day and Easter day too.
Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. All right. Now we're going to have a beautiful solo by Nasiah McGuire and Kamaya Copeland. Give them a hand if they come up.
Searching for a heart that will love him, and longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. And there's a God that walks over the world. Love me with your whole heart, he wants it all today. Serve me with your life now. He wants it all today. Bow down, let go of your rights. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. He wants it all today. So give it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth and searching for a heart that is desperate. And longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. And he says, love me with your whole. bow down, let go of your idols. He wants it all today.
He wants it all today.
He wants it all today. He wants it all. More of you, more of you. He wants it all today. All of you, more of you. He wants it all today. All of you, more of you. He wants it all today, today, today.
He wants it all today.
He wants it all today.
So give it all. Searching for a heart that will love him, and longing for a child that will give him their all.
Give it all, he wants it all.
Hallelujah, give him a hand. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Are you ready to give him your all today? Hallelujah, he wants it all, hallelujah. They said, bow down, let go of your idols. An idol can be anything. It can be your job. It can be a relationship. It can be your schoolwork, right? Are you ready to give it up? Hallelujah. Give it to the Lord. Hallelujah. Give him another hand. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So I'm going to keep moving right along. We have some more speeches. So I'm going to have Mackenzie Durant come up and give us a speech. You got it. Come on.
Happy Easter. Thank God for letting us go to school, because not everybody can go to school.
All right, you perfect. Good job. Beautiful. 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 All right. Next, we're going to have Jadea Kelly. Give her a hand as she comes up.
Truly and sincerely, from a heart of love, I wish your Easter blessing straight from heaven above.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Now we're going to have Malia Jones. Give her a hand as she come up.
Need a lot of clothes to get God's Easter favor. You need to know that Christ arose and take him as your Savior.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. All right, we're going to have Skylar Brown. Give her a hand as she comes up.
I got this new dress. I'm sure it fits me well. But I'm not the one for bragging. I'm sure this you can tell. There is one more thing that I need you to know, and that is that Jesus died and arose on Easter Day because he loves us so.
Beautiful, beautiful. Give her a hand. Hallelujah. All right, we're gonna call Ellie Terry to come on up and give us her speech. Give her a hand as she come up.
Worship heaven's King, sharing the hope and salvation he brings.
All right, beautiful. Give her a hand. Beautiful job. Next, we're going to have Elite Johnson. Give us his speech. He did a beautiful job with that scripture.
Just because he loved us so, Jesus died once long ago, but he rose on Easter Day. Now let all his children say, Jesus lives, Jesus lives. Oh, I'm happy Jesus lives. Just because he loved us so, Jesus died once long ago. But he rose on Easter Day. Now let all his children say, Jesus lives, Jesus lives. Oh, I'm happy Jesus lives.
Awesome. Give him a hand. Don't forget to take a bow, Elise. Take a bow. He's like, he done. So at this time, we have a special treat. We have a lot of talent in our pews, and sometimes we just don't know what we have. I'm going to ask Amari Richards to stand up. And as he's standing up, we're going to give him a hand. His sister, Riley Richards, is going to come and recite a poem written by him. He wrote this poem. Give him a hand. Yes.
Easter time is here again to celebrate our Savior's pain. Jesus, our Lord, so pure and true, died on the cross for me and you. He gave his life to set us free from sin and death for eternity. 3 days later, he rose again, victorious over death and sin. His love for us will never fade. In heaven's glory, he has paid. So let us celebrate this day and praise his name in every way. For Jesus Christ is risen indeed, our Savior, our King, our Lord, to heed. Let's spread the message far and wide that he is always by our side. So as we come for Easter eggs, remember Jesus who still begs to be your Savior, to be your friend. His love for you will never end.
All right. Give them both a hand. Good job, Riley. Good job, Amari. So proud of them. They both are my Sunday school students, so I'm super proud. All right. So at this time, we have a special treat. So it's going to be exciting. I know you're going to want to stand up, but we're going to ask if everybody can stay seated so everyone can see, because this is one of our young people. She's expressing herself to the Lord. So we're going to ask Alyssa Parrott at this time to come and give us a praise dance, such as the Lord has given her. Give her a hand as she come up. Give her another hand. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He's not dead. Hallelujah. He's risen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There's no need to cry. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Wipe your eyes. Hallelujah. We go through things, right? Hi, yo, don't see. I'm sorry. We go through things. Hallelujah. But he's alive. He's risen. We want to remind you he's risen. He can take you through. Hallelujah. Let's give God a praise. Hallelujah. 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 She just wanted to remind you guys today that he is risen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. At this time, we're going to move on. We have some more speeches. Hallelujah. So we're going to have Messiah McKelvin come give us a speech. And Mahogany. I'm sorry. Mahogany and Messiah McKelvin. Give them a hand and say, come up.
It's Easter morning. Shoes, joy, and bombing. Have a rest to everyone.
All right. Good job. Beautiful. Give them a hand. Love it. Beautiful curtsy. Beautiful, beautiful. All right. At this time, we're going to have Jamia and Jalea Ellison come and give us their speech. Give them a hand as they come up.
You are everything Jesus is to me.
It's okay.
A is for F. I was a friend he will be.
F is for he's a special person in my life.
G is for him take away the hardest in his life.
E is for he shows his endless love in every way.
And R is for remembering
Jesus showed on Easter day.
Give me a hand. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Good job. Beautiful. All right. At this time, I'm going to call Larry Shields III. Give him a hand. Come on.
The tomb is empty. Jesus is not there. He has risen on Easter day, his love with us to share.
All right, give him a hand, give him a hand. All right, we're gonna, I just love it, because it takes courage for these kids to get up. Some of them didn't even want to do it, and they're doing a really beautiful job. All right, we're gonna call Sister Tiana Lyons. Come on, give us your speech.
For he risen, and he said, Matthew 28:6. Come see where the place where the Lord lay. The monkey fleeing at the vine afar. Above him head and a cock is there.
Give her a hand, give her another hand. Good job. They got something to say for the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, at this time I'm going to ask Draylen Bush to come and give us his speech. Give him a hand as he comes.
Blessings. Blessings on Easter for all I pray. Jesus has risen, is here to stay. Jesus has risen for all I shout. Jesus is, he walks among us and that never doubt.
All right, Draylen. Good job. All right, we're gonna have Riley Dice come give us her speech. Give her a hand as she come up. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Happy Easter Day. Spring is everywhere we look. Hey, mommy. Spring is everywhere. Spring is everywhere we look. Spring is green as green could be. For love, my mommy and my. Amen. For God, for Wesley, for Jesus' name. Amen. For love, God, Chanel.
Give a hand. That's the way to end it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Beautiful, beautiful. That was so beautiful. Thank you so much, Riley. Thank you. All right. At this time, hallelujah. That's okay. Very beautiful. All right, so at this time, we have another special treat. We have our young ladies who are going to do a pantomime of the old rugged cross, and we're going to have Sister Katrina Coleman sing the song while they're doing their pantomime. Give them a hand as they come up.
On a hill
this time, we're going to have offering done by Elder Kenneth George. Give him a hand.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord again. Hallelujah. Children are the heritage of the Lord. We'll give them one more hand right now. Thank you. Hallelujah. What time is it?
It's offering time.
All right. It's offering time. Let us bow our heads as we stand in the presence of the Lord. Let us all stand in the presence of the Lord. It's offering time. Father God, it's in your precious and your holy name that we come before your presence this morning, Lord, and we thank you. Thank you, Lord God, for all that you've done, all that you're doing, and all that you're going to do. Thank you for blessing these children this morning, oh God. You are our great God and Savior. And now, Lord, we're asking you to bless the offering today. Oh God, let it go forth for thy glory and thy praise and uplifting and the building of the church. Oh God, and we will be careful to give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. And everybody said in Jesus' name. And now the deacons, you can follow the deacons. Thank you.
Blessings on Easter for all our pray.
Give them a hand. All right, beautiful. Good job.
You did a beautiful job.
All right. As I mentioned, we got a lot of talent in the pews, and we don't know what we have. We're going to give them an opportunity. So at this time, we're going to have a spoken word. I think it's spoken word. By Shaquille. Brother Shaquille Hardy, give him a hand and come up.
Praise God. How y'all doing? It's good to see all the beautiful faces in here. I give an honor to the Spirit of Christ, who's the head of my life. To my granddad, District Elder Jeffrey Davis, and Pastor Brown, and Ella George, and Benita Darrow. God bless you, sir. All right, I'm going to just do 5 minutes, just 5 minutes, all right? Amen. Calvary demonstrated Christ over death and God's capacity to keep his word. The defining event of our faith in church is in the resurrection of Christ. Calvary not only demonstrated his power over death, but God's captivity to keep his word. As I go to my seat, I leave you with this. What do you say on resurrection day? Therefore, if anyone in Christ, the creation has come, the old has gone, and the new is there. Praise be to God, our Father, and our Lord Jesus Christ. He is not here. He has risen. God bless you.
Thank you so much, Shaquille. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We appreciate Shaquille coming up. He had to warm up to the idea, but he rose to the challenge. We appreciate that. Good job, Shaquille. Give him a hand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right, at this time, we're going to have a song by the children directed by Sister Katrina. It's He Rose.
They crucified my Savior and nailed him to the cross. They crucified my Savior and nailed him to the cross. They crucified my Savior and nailed him to the cross. And the Lord
will bear
my spirit home.
He rose.
He rose.
He rose.
He rose.
He rose.
He rose from the dead.
He rose.
He rose.
He rose.
He rose.
Mean, Sister Alicia Lennon. Following her sharing with us what the resurrection means, we'll have a skit by our teenagers, The Resurrection. Okay. Get right in.
Praise the Lord. What does resurrection mean? Growing up in church, we hear about the death and resurrection of Jesus. Do we ever think about how, if Jesus simply died, we would not have Christianity today? The resurrection is everything to do with our faith. The death of Jesus was the necessary sacrifice for our sins, but the resurrection was the victory. When we think about resurrecting something, we are bringing back to life. Ephesians 2 and 1 tells us that we were once dead in our sins. But then Ephesians 2, 4 and 5 goes on to say, but because of his great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive with Christ, even when we were dead in our trespasses. It is by grace you have been saved. Adam and Eve lived in a perfect world with perfect bodies, and there was no sin. When they ate from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, they sinned, and death was the consequence. Our sins lead to death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Christ. Jesus had to resurrect himself. He needed to defeat death for us so we could be brought back and restored to the life God intended for us. Sin separates, but Jesus resurrects. Anastasis is the word for resurrection in the Greek. Strong's Concordance says that anastasia is a standing up, for example, a resurrection, a raising up, or rising. Christ's physical resurrection is the foundation of Christianity, which also guarantees the future resurrection of all believers. If you have ever participated in a Resurrection Sunday service, then you might be familiar with the call and response, he has risen indeed. This comes from the message of the angel at Jesus' tomb. In multiple places we read, he is not here, he has risen. Matthew 28, 5 and 6, Mark 16 and 6, and Luke 24 and 7. Jesus was on a mission. We see his death, resurrection, and ascension in scripture. Jesus raised himself back to life and then ascended to heaven and sits at the right hand of God, our Father. Because of Jesus' resurrection, we too will be resurrected one day. Our resurrection will take place at the future return of Christ. When we die, we immediately enter into the presence of the Lord, but the final resurrection has not happened yet. And when it does, we will know it because Christ's return will be known by all. Roman soldiers stand guard outside of the tomb where Jesus is laying. Suddenly, there is a tremendous noise and the earth begins to shake. An angel appears and rolls the stone away as the trembling guards fall to the ground in fear.
What was that noise? And what is that?
I don't know. Let's get out of here.
Nearby, a group of women walked slowly, talking amongst themselves.
It's the least we can do for him, to anoint his body with spices.
I just wish we could have done it on the evening of his death. I know it would have been so much better then. I know Joseph and Nicodemus prepared his body for burial, but I want to do something for him too.
How are we going to get along with our Lord? It's so unfair.
I know how you feel, but right now I'm wondering how we'll get the stone away from the tomb. It will be much too heavy for us to move.
Maybe together the four of us can roll it away.
Don't be full of Salome. That stone is much too heavy for us to move.
Look, the stone is rolled away. Who could have done that?
The women all run to the tomb and stare in shock and fear.
You probably had a bad dream. Either that or you're both drunk.
We are not drunk. Surely you can tell that by looking at us.
Then it must have been a dream.
But the tomb is empty and the body is gone, I tell you.
If the tomb is empty, his disciples must have stolen his body while he slept. He predicted that he'd rise again on the third day. So they have stolen the body so that they can claim that he's come back to life.
Maybe he did come back to life.
That's absurd. The council has discussed this matter, and there is no way that can be possible.
But how do you explain the man and the white, the angel?
You two take this money and tell everyone that the disciple stole his body while you slept. That was just part of your dream.
But we weren't asleep. We had the night watch and we did not go to sleep.
Of course you did. That's how the disciples were able to steal the body.
But we would be in serious trouble as we went to sleep during our watch.
Don't worry about that. The council and I will see to it that nothing happens to you. Just tell everyone that the disciples came during the night and stole him away while you were sleeping. And forget all about the angel you think you saw. The disciples rolled the stone away when they took the body. Now get going.
Now come the woman to tell Peter and John what they have witnessed at the tomb.
Oh, Peter, they have taken the Lord away from the tomb, and I don't know where they have laid him.
He is risen. The angel said so.
Mary's right. That's what the angel said.
But it can't be so.
Let's go see for ourselves.
Come, Mary, let's tell the other disciples.
No, I can't. I'm going with Peter and John. You all go ahead.
And so the women depart, and Mary Magdalene follows Peter and John back to the tomb. The disciples run ahead, but John arrives first and peers in.
Look, John, here's the linen cloth that he was wrapped in. And look, it's the handkerchief from around his head. He's not here.
He is alive. He has risen. Hallelujah. He has risen from the dead. Let's go tell the others.
Mary Magdalene is left alone, and she weeps bitterly in her distress.
Woman, why are you crying? Whom are you seeking?
Sir, are you the gardener? If you have taken my Lord away, tell me where you are, where you have laid him, and I will take him away.
Mary.
We're in Boni.
Don't cling to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go and tell the others that I ascend to the Father, my Father, your Father, my God, your God.
Do I have to go? I'd like to just stay here with you.
Yes, you must go and tell them so they will believe. Go and tell them that I am alive and I have risen.
So Mary runs off to tell the disciples the good news.
He rose
from the dead. He rose from the dead. He rose from the dead. And the Lord will bear my spirit home.
He rose
from the dead.
He's risen.
alive.
He's risen.
He's
hallelujah.
Risen.
He's alive.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. He rose from the dead. Let's give our kids another hand. Amen. Yes. Okay, praise God. Let's give them another hand. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. As I was looking at some of these kids, I held them as little babies and presented them to the Lord. And now, look what God has done. Isn't God good? Hallelujah. He's good to us. He's good to us. Praise God. Now it's come time for the word of God. The Bible teaches us that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that cometh out of the mouth of God. And certainly the Lord has blessed us today with one of our young ministers. Amen. He has a word from the Lord for you. And so I just encourage you to listen attentively as a man of God come to us today with the word of God. Amen. In the person of Minister Darrell Simmons, we're going to just greet him with a hearty amen. Amen. Praise God. Sister Sienna Adams, she's going to bless us. The next voice you will hear today is that of the man of God bringing to us the word of God.
Light of the world, you stepped out into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you above a life spent with. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God, you're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven. I'll never know how much
Come, oh come, oh come, oh come. yes, you are. Just come. Come on, come on, come on, come on. So come, so come, so come. Come see the place where the Lord used to lay, because he's risen. Oh, come and bow down.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on here, church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. You can do better than that. Hallelujah. Oh, God. Hallelujah. Let's give our great God a praise. Hallelujah. Come on now. Let's give our God a great praise. We can do better than that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He hung, hallelujah, from the sixth to the ninth hour. He, hallelujah, bled and died. Hallelujah. For you and I, we can do better than that. Let's give God a praise in this house. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to your name. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. This is holy ground. This is a place, hallelujah, you can, hallelujah, take off your shoes. Hallelujah. Stretch your arms out. Hallelujah. And give God everything, hallelujah, that you owe him in the name of Jesus. Let us give our young people a hand. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. This took time. This took planning. Hallelujah. This wasn't an overnight thing. I thank God for, hallelujah, our young people. Giving honor to the Spirit of Christ, who is first in my life. Hallelujah. Giving honor to our, hallelujah, our pastor, hallelujah, Bishop Ken. Hallelujah. Pastor Elder Jeff Davis, hallelujah, and Pastor Homer Brown and their wives in the name of Jesus. I thank God, hallelujah, and I salute also my wife, hallelujah, that is in the house, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord, hallelujah, for what I've heard, hallelujah, from a long time. Behind a good man, there also is a very good woman, hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I just truly thank God for my being here. I thank God for you all. Hallelujah. All of y'all look so wonderful tonight. I mean, not tonight, but today. Hallelujah. I just give God all the praise because, hallelujah, I can just, can I be truthful with y'all? I tell y'all, I didn't have nothing. I didn't have nothing. But it took God. It took just coming into prayer, hallelujah, each and every day. And God gave it to me. And I truly thank him. I praise him today because not only did he die for me, but he hung up there without a cry, a complaint. He could have came down. He could have said anything. But he hung there. And he showed himself worthy of the death, the burial, and resurrection. Hallelujah. Come on, we gonna dive in this thing. It's time to get to the meat and potatoes. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But before we get into this word, I want to just ask God to render himself, hallelujah, unto me and also unto you. Let us bow our heads in the name of Jesus. Father, in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Father, we, hallelujah, need a word. Father, I ask in the name of Lord Jesus Christ that you use these lips of clay, oh, God, to speak a word to your people. Father, get the glory and honor and praise out of my life. Oh, God, that you may be lifted up in the name of Jesus. Father, let a word be spoken to someone in the name, Lord Jesus Christ, that will not be afraid to come forth and say, what must I do to be saved? Father, hallelujah, touch their hearts and their minds right now, hallelujah, in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Don't allow them to be, hallelujah, scared or afraid, but let them come forth, hallelujah, with boldness to your throne. Father, use this service today, hallelujah, as a memorial. Use this service today, Lord God, to fill someone with the Holy Ghost, to baptize somebody in the name of Jesus Christ. And let all God's people say in Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Can you turn your Bibles with me to Matthew, St. Matthew, the 26th chapter. and I'll be covering a couple of scriptures. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And when you have it, can you say amen? Thank you, Jesus. Matthew, the 26th chapter, the first, I'm going to read the first and the second verse, and I'll be skipping and going from the 26th to the 6th all the way to the 13th. And the Bible reads as wise. And it came to pass, when Jesus had finished all these sayings, he said unto his disciples, ye know that after 2 days is the feast of the Passover, and the Son of Man is betrayed to be crucified. The 6th verse. Now when Jesus was in Bethany, in the house of Simon the leper, there came unto him a woman having an alabaster box of very precious ointment, and poured it on his head as he sat at meat. But when his disciples saw it, they had indignation, saying, to what purpose is this waste? For this ointment might have been sold for much and given to the poor. When Jesus understood it, he said unto them, why trouble ye the woman? For she hath wrought a good work upon me. For ye have the poor always with you, but me ye have not always. For in that she had poured the ointment on my body, she did it for my burial. Verily I say unto you, wheresoever this gospel shall be preached in the whole world, there shall also this, that this woman have done, be told for a memorial of her. And can you also turn with me, go to the 55th verse, and I'll be reading it down to the, excuse me, all the way down close to about the 64th verse. In that same hour said Jesus to the multitudes, are ye come out as against a thief with swords and staves for to take me? And sat daily with you teaching in the temple, and ye laid no hold on me. But all this was done that the scripture of the prophet might be fulfilled. Then all the disciples forsook him and fled. And they that had laid hold on Jesus led him away to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the scribes and the elders were assembled. But Peter followed him afar off unto the high priest's palace, and went in and sat with the servants to see the end. Now the chief priests and elders and all the council sought false witness against Jesus to put him to death, but found none. Yea, though many false witnesses came, yet found they none. At the last came two false witnesses and said, this fellow said, I am able to destroy the temple of God and to build it in 3 days. And the high priest arose and said unto him, answer thou nothing. What is it which these witnesses against thee? But Jesus held his peace. And the high priest answered and said unto him, I adjure thee by the living God that thou tell us whether thou be the Christ, the Son of God. Jesus said unto him, thou hast said it. Nevertheless, I say unto you, hereafter shall ye see the Son of Man sitting on the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven. And if I could use for a thought on this morning, Jesus, the great high priest. I'm going to say that again. Jesus, the great high priest. The same, hallelujah, great high priest, hallelujah, that went before Caiaphas. Hallelujah, the same high priest, hallelujah, hallelujah, had scribes and elders, hallelujah, was trying to find indignation against, hallelujah, you and our Savior. Praise the name of our God. The same high priest, hallelujah, hallelujah, went to Pilate, hallelujah. And all this time, They couldn't find no fault against a man, hallelujah, that, hallelujah, just walked the earth, hallelujah, not only, hallelujah, walked the earth, but healed the sick, hallelujah, raised the dead, hallelujah. He did all this, hallelujah, but still you have people that find some type of, hallelujah, problem with a man that has no, hallelujah, sin upon his life. What, hallelujah, kind of God would you, hallelujah, just condemn him because of something that you feel? Praise the name of God. He's a God that loves. He's a God that saves. Why would you, hallelujah, nail my God to the cross? Hallelujah. But not only nail him to the cross, you, hallelujah, put thorns on his head. You didn't, hallelujah, not only do that, you ripped him of his clothing. You didn't, hallelujah, give him, hallelujah, the right type of clothing. Hallelujah. What type of people would do a God like that? Hallelujah. We serve a God that is almighty. But as a people, hallelujah, we walk to and fro on this earth, hallelujah, not giving God praise or thank for nothing. Hallelujah, do we deserve him? Do we deserve the fact, hallelujah, that we get to wake up each and every day, hallelujah, out of our beds and we can roll, hallelujah, and turn our feet, hallelujah, and put them on the floor? Do you give God praise? Hallelujah, you can, hallelujah, say to yourself, I'm like the scribes and the elders, hallelujah, because I haven't gave my life to Jesus Christ yet. I have not, hallelujah, put myself in position to do the things that God would have me to do. So what should I do, hallelujah, to be saved? What should I do to be more like Christ? How can I be a representative of the man, hallelujah, that hung to the sixth and the ninth hour, hallelujah, did not complain, did not shed a tear, but hallelujah, just looked upon him and say, my God, hallelujah, have mercy upon their souls because they know not what they do. Hallelujah. See, sometimes, hallelujah, it's kind of crazy when you look at me and you say, well, what is this man talking about? What I'm talking about is, hallelujah, we've, hallelujah, lived in sin, hallelujah, way too long. We've, hallelujah, been treading on thin ice way too long. We, hallelujah, God have given us chance after chance after chance after chance. And then, hallelujah, you have the nerve, hallelujah, when you come into the house, hallelujah, to look a certain type of way. We're talking about a Savior. Hallelujah. We're talking about a God, hallelujah, that had people, hallelujah, going against him, had the elders continuously, regardless if he was at the temple, no matter where he was, hallelujah, he stood and was preaching the gospel. He was giving good news to those who needed. Hallelujah, when you have somebody, hallelujah, even at your job, sometimes you might have to give a word to somebody. But hallelujah, there's always going to be that one, hallelujah, that's, hallelujah, filled with the enemy, that's going to try to stop, hallelujah, what God is trying to do. Are you trying to say to that person that's trying to change their life, what will it take, hallelujah, for you to change your life today? What would it take for you to give your life to Christ? Don't be afraid, hallelujah, to say yes, Lord, and give God everything that's due to him, because, hallelujah, you would rather give God your life on this side, hallelujah, because when you're dead and in the ground, there's no more time. When you close your eyes, you don't have another opportunity. You don't have another chance, but you have an opportunity right now to change your life, to give it over to Jesus Christ, who's somebody who died for you and I, somebody who, hallelujah, gave it all up and did not look to the right or the left, but he looked up to the sky and said, my God, why have you forsaken me? And not only that, I know sometimes we be in a pickle, and sometimes, hallelujah, our life is all messed up and tore up from the floor, but God said, I'm with you always until the end of the ages. Why not give him praise when it's time now? Hey, my Savior, we've wasted too much time. Hallelujah. You are not, hallelujah, going to live, hallelujah, to see 100. Hallelujah. I'm not just saying that, but I mean it, because at the simple fact, it's so many people, hallelujah, out here just dying. Hallelujah, left and right, young people at that. Hallelujah. We got to get it together, saints. We got to pour out, hallelujah, unto these young people. Hallelujah, because we are representative of Jesus Christ. Lord, I give you praise. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. I feel my help. Thank you, Jesus. See, it doesn't take much. Hallelujah. It doesn't take much. Only thing that it takes is for somebody to say, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. I know sometimes we'll sit there in that seat, hallelujah, and we'll, hallelujah, have these rationals in our minds. Hallelujah, man, should I go up there and, hallelujah, just make a fool of myself? Why not make a fool? Praise the name of God. God made a fool. Hallelujah. They made a fool out of our Savior. Hallelujah. When they nailed him to the cross, they made a fool out of him. When they whipped him, they made a fool out of him. But they little did they know, hallelujah, even, hallelujah, let me take you back. Even, hallelujah, at the prayer, hallelujah, when, hallelujah, Jesus Christ, hallelujah, was coming out of the prayer. Praise the name of God. You had this one called Judas, hallelujah, who, praise the name of God, who wanted to just go against Jesus. That's when the enemy came in. I think sometimes people would say, hallelujah, the devil came in Judas after the supper. No, I beg to differ. Even when the woman with the alabaster box, hallelujah, when she poured that oil, you had the, hallelujah, Bible say the disciples had indignation. But not only all of the disciples, it was that one. Hallelujah, he had something to say. Hallelujah, why is it you worrying about, hallelujah, what a woman does for Jesus Christ? She was doing it for his crucifixion. That's what the Bible said. Hallelujah, she was doing it for his burial. Hallelujah. Now here comes Judas, hallelujah, coming by. Hallelujah, the one who I kissed, that's the one you, hallelujah, lay hands on. So, hallelujah, he kissed him. Now they're laying hands on our Savior. Hallelujah, the great high priest. The same great high priest, hallelujah, that wakes you up. The great high priest that gives you breath in your body. The great high priest, hallelujah, that watch over you while you sleep. The same great high priest, when you walk out your door, there's nothing happening to you because he's watching over you. The great high priest, the one, hallelujah, that gets you to, hallelujah, you can talk to your loved ones on the phone. The same high priest, hallelujah, didn't take your life when he should have took your life. The same high priest, hallelujah, when you just walking up and down these streets or whatever else you doing, hallelujah, he could take any time he want, hallelujah, but y'all sitting around him. Hallelujah, stop playing. Stop playing with the great high priest. I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to myself too. Hallelujah. Because we all need him. I know sometimes it's hard to sit back or even tell somebody what's going on in your life because, hallelujah, you don't want nobody else to be talking about your business or spilling it like they're turning on water. Hallelujah. But there comes a time that you either got to get on your knees and pray and say, Lord, put somebody in my life that I can, hallelujah, trust to tell my secrets. Hallelujah, put somebody in my life that can pray for me. Put somebody in my life not only to lay hands with me, but, hallelujah, to just get down, hallelujah, and come close and bear this burden with me. Hallelujah, sometimes we need to yoke up with some people, hallelujah, and walk in the fire with them and stop sitting around here and, hallelujah, pointing the finger, praise the name of God and saying, well, why sister so-and-so looking like that? Or why brother so-and-so looking? What you need to do is, hallelujah, yoke up with them and walk through the fire. Then you will see why, hallelujah, this person is feeling the way they feel because they're trying to get next to the great high priest. Hallelujah. God has been good to every last one of us. Hallelujah. God has been so amazing to every one of us. So why not? You can't club for the rest of your life. You can't drink for the rest of your life. You can't smoke for the rest of your life. So what you seeing right here, standing before you, you see not once, not twice, but three times. Hallelujah, a walking miracle. God could have took me out a long time ago, but he had a purpose for me. And I'm going to walk in my purpose by the help of the Lord. Because my great high priest, he walks with me. He talks with me. Hallelujah. I don't hear him all the time because it might not be ready for me to hear him. Hallelujah. But I know he talks to some of you. Hallelujah. The great high priest, he knows your secrets, but he won't blot out a word. The great high priest, he's waiting on you. Hallelujah. For you to surrender. For you to, hallelujah, just give way. hallelujah, these jobs that you've been searching for all these years, this certain job that you're saying, well, Lord, I ain't got enough money. Praise the name of God. I need to pay this. I need to pay that. But if you give way unto God, if you hallelujah, surrender, when I say surrender, total surrender, give it all up. Stop sitting around here playing. Stop acting like, hallelujah, you don't need him. But in deep down in your heart, Lord, I need you. I need you to fix this brokenness inside of me. I need you to fix the way that I feel about my mother, about my sister, about whoever it is that's, hallelujah, that's tormented me. Lord, I surrender. Take this away from me that I can be whole. Hallelujah, release whatever it is that's causing me to be broken. People of God, today is your day. I'm going to say this like my assistant pastor, say, today is your day. You can get it because Jesus is here right now, the great high priest. He's here to lift that burden. He's here to save. Don't look around to your left or your right to see, I wonder if he going to go first. I wonder if she going to go first. Why don't all y'all come first? Hallelujah. Let God do a work. I guarantee you, he'll do a work. And if you feel like you don't want to come up, close your eyes right now and tell God what you want. Tell him what you want. Matter of fact, I double dare you to tell him what you want right now. Tell him what you want. You spend so much time, hallelujah. We'll spend, hallelujah, a whole hour, sometimes 3 to 4 hours on Facebook, Instagram. But can you spend an hour right now closing your eyes and tell Jesus what you want? It don't matter what it is. If it's spiritual, financial, whatever. If your bills ain't paid, tell him what you want. For the Bible says we have not because we ask not. And don't ask in a mess. Give it to him. Sometimes you got to just be for real with yourself. Sometimes you got to lay aside all the foolishness and say, Jesus, here I am. Take me. I'm broken. I'm full of sin. Just wipe me clean. Give me what I need to be whole because I done been searching, hallelujah, my left side to my right side. I done been to every woman house that, hallelujah, that I can be to, but Lord, they're not doing nothing for me. Do it for me now. Lord, I praise you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You only have one shot. One shot. Praise the Lord. Yesterday, I buried my cousin. 51 years old. 51. At the prime of his life. 51. I told him about Jesus. Asked him to come. But who am I to put him in heaven or hell? Only thing I can say is, He had his relationship with God because I used to get text messages all the time. Hallelujah. I get text messages now from a brother. I'm not going to point him out. And I appreciate him. I thank the Lord for him. But what I want most, I want him to get filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. So when the Lord save him, hallelujah, all these things that he been praying for, he won't, God will open that door for him. When the Lord say he'll open up the windows of heaven and he'll pour you out a blessing, you won't have room enough to see. That's not, hallelujah, something that he just said. That's a fact. Hallelujah. Praise the name of God. Can I let y'all in a little secret? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. Me and my wife been married for 7 years. Hallelujah. In our first trimester year, praise the name of God. Hallelujah. We were living in an apartment. Hallelujah. Then the next year, hallelujah, we were still in that same apartment. Let me tell you just how good God is. God will use people to be a blessing to you. God not only will use people, God will use your enemy. Hallelujah. He'll put your enemy at a footstool to give you what you want. Now, this is how God works for me. This is why I don't mind blessing Jesus. This is why I don't mind giving the high priest all the praise, because he was the same God, hallelujah, where we stand at right now at 1264, in 2 years, God gave us that house, hallelujah, and now you can't tell me how good God is. Some people, it'll take 5 or 6, maybe 10 years, hallelujah, to get into that house, because you know how certain things go. You got to get a credit report, you got to get all this other stuff, you got to get paperwork done, but see, Jesus will pass through all the paperwork, and God will just get to you right here, right now. Only thing you got to do is surrender. Only thing you got to do is move out yourself way. Because sometimes you can be in the flesh and it can stop you. Hallelujah. Stop letting the devil talk to you and just slide out and just come and say, yeah, I'm ready to be saved. Yeah, I'm ready to be baptized. Yes, I'm ready to give my life to the Lord. I'm not talking about, hallelujah, you raising your hand and saying, yeah, I take the Lord as my personal savior. I'm talking about coming to this altar, slobbing, whatever it takes to get this demon up out you, calling on the name of Jesus until you get tired. Hallelujah. It's time out. There's a lot of us, hallelujah, that are here. Praise the name of God. We're going through something. Hallelujah. If these kids didn't inspire you, if these kids didn't, hallelujah, I mean, you got to understand, this is the generation. The Bible says train them up as the way it should go, and they will not forget it. You got to train them up in the word. You can't train them up, hallelujah, putting on your sad the best. You can't train them up talking about, well, baby, I'm finna go, you know what I'm saying, I'm finna go out. No, train them up in the word so that they'll know better. Too many young people, hallelujah, just don't, hallelujah, don't recognize, hallelujah, older people for nothing. When we was coming up, it was yes, ma'am, no, ma'am. And when you see somebody sitting on the porch, you would say, how you doing, Miss So-and-so? Praise the name of God. Now young people, hallelujah, just walk past your house and look at you like you done something wrong. But we must understand, people of God, that we're serving a great high priest. The same Jesus that bore and died. He gave his life. I'm sitting up here trying to hold back tears because I love him just that much. Because when I say y'all looking up here, y'all looking at a person that's been a drug dealer. That literally almost got his life took. Not once, but twice. You're looking at a walking miracle. There's many people up in here that's a walking miracle. People done been to the hospital. People who almost just done flatlined. But they're here today because of God's grace. Who wouldn't want to serve, hallelujah, a God like that? Who wouldn't want to give their life to a God like that? This, we're talking about the great high priest, Jesus, the one who watches over you, the one who gave his life for you. I know it's hard. And for men, I know it's hard. We want to put this tough and steery on. But, bruh, put it down. It's time. And then my closing saying right now, this is my close. Somebody need to come to Jesus. I don't care who you are. Somebody need to repent. I mean, because if you have been, if you backslidden, and if you feel like, preacher, I don't want to do it because I don't want nobody to ridicule me. They ridicule Jesus. What does that make you? It don't make you no better. Come to Jesus. Come on now. We got a lot of young men, young women, older people, middle age. Come to Jesus while it's still time. I want to thank you for letting God use me. Come to Jesus. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. As the choir prepare to bless us, we will come to our Holy Communion. Great is thy faithfulness, O God. You love us. You blessed us. Great is thy mercy towards me. Great is thy towards me. Great is your love.
Day after day.
Hallelujah.
Forever faithful towards me.
worthy of the praise. He's worthy. That song just came into my heart.
The great high priest, the merciful Lord,
faithful,
the God that can look beyond our faults, see the things that we need. Paul chapter Hebrews talks about this great high priest. Glory to God. That we have a priest, a high priest, a great high priest that has been touched like you were touched. He went through the things that you and I go through. He did it, but he did it without sin. He wanted to understand us. He wanted to understand our needs. How do they do it? So God came down on this earth, took the form of a servant. Hallelujah to God. And he walked the way that we walk. He talked the way that we talk. He wanted to experience these things. So this great high priest that the preacher is telling us about today, when he rose, he went into heaven to be our advocate. He speaks for us right now. Glory to God. When we come to him, he speaks to us. All right, the choir's going to bless us, and we're going to our communion.
Come down from the
Jesus. And everybody said amen. Jesus. Lift your hands and give God the praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood.
Hallelujah. Oh, the blood, redeeming blood.
Thank you.
Jesus' blood was shed for me. Oh, the blood, saving blood. Calvary, magnified, crucified, for my sins he bled and died, and oh, how precious is the blood.
One more time, oh, the blood. As we remember the Lord Jesus Christ, the body which was broken, the blood which was shed for you and I, oh God, what he asked us to do is to remember me, this do in remembrance of me. Therefore I say unto you today that the Lord Jesus, on the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread. After he possessed it, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said to them, take ye, this is my body, which was broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And after the same manner, he took the cup. And he said this to his disciples. This is the cup of the New Testament in my blood. This is my blood that was shed for you. This is the New Testament in my blood. Drink it, y'all love it. As often as you eat this bread and drink of this cup, you do show forth the Lord's death until he comes. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yeah. They're singing.
Glory to his name, precious name. Glory to his name. Dear to my heart, what a blood of thine. Singing glory to his name.
I am so wondrously saved from sin. Jesus so sweetly